Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss an important concept of physical chemistry, that is from gaseous state, and it is a subpart of kinetic molecular theory of gases. A question was given in 2016 advanced paper based on this concept, and the concept which we are going to discuss now is collision parameters, especially collision number and collision frequency. For a gas molecule, according to kinetic molecular theory, a gas molecule is imagined to be a tiny hot sphere, and each gas molecule is expected to move with an average velocity of u bar. Though the molecular velocities of all the molecules are different, but each of the molecule is expected to have a velocity of u bar. Now, when the gas molecules involve in collisions, we get these terms like collision number, collision frequency, mean free path, etc. So, what is collision number? According to kinetic molecular theory, collision number is the number of collisions made by a molecule per unit time in a given volume. We give a formula for collision number, in short, as root 2 pi sigma square u bar into n star, where n star is number of gas molecules per unit volume, and sigma is called collision diameter. Collision diameter, it is actually the distance between two gas molecules, which are distance between centers of the two colliding gas molecules. Let us know its importance. Before that, know the other terms. U bar is called average velocity, and it is measured, it is related to temperature with a formula root over 8RT by pi m, where capital M is gram molecular weight of gas, and the other terms you are familiar with, R is gas constant and T is absolute temperature. This can be also written in this form, root over 8kT by pi m, pi small m, where small m is mass of each molecule. So the conversion is made in such a way, R by Na, capital M is mass of Avogadro number of atoms or molecules, and R by Na is nothing but K, which is called Boltzmann constant. So this is conversion of u bar, and sigma is the collision diameter. Let us derive this expression with some assumptions. The main assumption to be made here is, when two gas molecules are approaching to make a collision, their average velocity is not taken to be u bar. It is the average velocity of a gas molecule which is involved in a collision is different from u bar. To get that value of average velocity of a colliding molecule, the two gas molecules approach to collide are assumed to approach on an average in perpendicular direction. This is an assumption. The two gas molecules which are approaching to collide with each other are assumed to approach in a perpendicular direction. Consider the two gas molecules which are approaching in this direction perpendicularly to make a collision here. Then the accurate average velocity for such colliding molecules is taken along the line joining centers of the two colliding molecules. That value then becomes root 2 u bar from the properties of triangle. If this is u bar and this is a right angle triangle, then the value of average velocity is equal to root 2 u bar. Now, for a gas molecule involved in a collision, average velocity is taken as root 2 u bar. And the effective area covered by a gas molecule moving is not pi r square, it becomes pi sigma square if r is the radius of circle. If a gas molecule with normal area of it is taken as pi r square, its actual effective area covered by the gas molecule is the area into which the center of other colliding molecule cannot penetrate. The effective area covered by a gas molecule is the area into which the center of other colliding gas molecule cannot approach. See, if these two molecules are assumed to involve in collision, then this is the distance up to which the center of other colliding molecule can approach, but not into this area. So the effective area covered by a gas molecule involved in a collision is not pi r square, it is taken pi sigma square, where sigma is called as collision diameter. Now, if root 2 u bar is the average velocity of a colliding molecule, the distance traveled by that molecule in unit time, that is per second, becomes root 2 u bar. The distance traveled by a molecule in unit time is nothing but average velocity. That velocity is root 2 u bar. So, the distance traveled by the gas molecule in unit time is root 2 u bar. The distance traveled by the molecule is root 2 u bar, and effective area covered by the gas molecule is pi sigma square. Then the total volume swept by the molecule in moving per unit time, in moving per unit time, will become the product of these two, pi sigma square into root 2 u bar. The total volume becomes area into distance. Okay. So volume is equal to pi sigma square into root 2 u bar, or root 2 pi sigma square u bar. Okay, this is volume swept by each molecule per second while moving. Now, if n star is the number of molecules assumed to be in unit volume, the number of molecules per unit volume is considered as n star, then the total number of molecules present in the V volume, which we discussed now, will become the product of n star with V. N star into V is the total number of molecules present in unit, in given volume V. Since this molecule is moving and covering entire volume V per unit time, and n star V molecules are already present in that volume, the total number of collisions made by this molecule while covering this V volume will be equal to number of molecules present in that volume. For example, a molecule is moving to cover certain volume. In that volume, 10 molecules are already there. Then the total number of collisions that can be made by this molecule while covering entire volume will become 10. That means number of collisions present, number of molecules present in unit volume itself is equal to number of collisions made by this molecule. So that means the n star into V is actually number of molecules present in given volume, that itself is equal to number of collisions made by the molecule in given volume per unit time. Actually, the number of collisions made by a molecule per unit time in that given volume is equal to collision number. So that is how we get an expression for collision number as root 2 pi sigma square u bar of n star. So look at this equation. This is nothing but this expression we have. So this is how we can derive an expression for collision number. Now we are going to discuss an important aspect of collision number, that is dependence of it on pressure and temperature. Pressure and temperature. From ideal gas equation, from PV is equal to nRT, PV is equal to nRT, we can write PV is equal to N by NaRT, and N by V is actually, capital N is number of molecules, and N by V is nothing but number of molecules per unit volume. Number of molecules per unit volume is nothing but N star. So this N star is equal to, look at this expression and see, N by V is equal to P by P into Na by RT, or P by KT, R by Na is again equal to Boltzmann constant, k. That means n star is proportional to p by t. N star is proportional to p by t, and the average velocity term present in it, it is equal to 8 kt by pi m, which is also proportional to root over temperature. Now u bar is proportional to root t and n star is proportional to p by t. Then what is this z1 proportional to? The value of z1 is proportional to p by t of root t, that is p by root t. So this is proportionality of collision number with pressure and temperature. But you can explain the effect of each of pressure and temperature when the others are constant. For example, at constant temperature z1 is proportional to p, and at constant pressure z1 is proportional to 1 by root t. But at constant volume we have to apply Gay-Lussac's law to get relation of pressure and temperature. Look at this. If it is constant volume, you know P is directly proportional to temperature for a given moles of gas according to Gay-Lussac's law. Therefore z1 is proportional to, we have z1 is proportional to P by root T. So this can be now taken as P proportional to T. So P by root T is proportional to T by root T, or it is proportional to root over T. If it is to be converted in terms of pressure, then Z1 is proportional to P by T is proportional to P. So we can write Z1 is proportional to P by root T, or it is again proportional to root over P. At constant pressure and constant temperature, the relations are different from the constant volume. At constant volume, collision number is either directly proportional to root T or directly proportional to root P. But at constant temperature, it is directly proportional to P. At constant temperature, directly proportional to pressure. And at constant pressure, it is directly inversely proportional to square root of temperature. So this is how we can study the effect of pressure and temperature on collision number.